Hey there, folks. Welcome back to Financial Future. Today, I've got some exciting news to share with you about potential boosts to your Social Security benefits. So, let's dive right in. In this video, I'm thrilled to break down the latest report detailing a potential increase of $638 per month for Social Security beneficiaries. Yes, you heard that right. This extra amount could be a game changer for over 71 million beneficiaries, including retirees, those on disability, SSDI, and individuals receiving Supplemental Security Income, SSI. Imagine what an additional $638 could do for your monthly budget. It's truly remarkable, especially considering the ongoing discussions in Congress about increasing benefits by a mere $200. But with this report shedding light on the possibility of tripling that amount, it's time to pay attention. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty details of this report. It spans over 23 years, from 2000 to 2023, analyzing the cost of living adjustments that beneficiaries received during this time. While benefits increased by around 60%, expenses skyrocketed by nearly 150% over the same period. That's a massive disparity that cannot be ignored. If benefits had kept pace with real expenses, the average beneficiary would be receiving an extra $638 per month right now. But unfortunately, that hasn't been the case. The current COLA system is falling short of accurately reflecting the rising cost of living, leaving many beneficiaries struggling to make ends meet. Now, you might wonder why this discrepancy exists. Well, it's a complex issue. While some speculate about intentional oversight to maintain Social Security's financial stability, the bottom line is that beneficiaries are getting shortchanged. With prices of essentials like food, housing, and transportation steadily climbing, it's time for a change. The COLA system needs to be revamped to ensure that beneficiaries can keep up with the real cost of living. So, what can we do about it? Well, staying informed and advocating for fair adjustments to Social Security benefits is a good start. By sharing this information and raising awareness, we can work towards securing a brighter financial future for all. Now let's talk another topic. There's a new bill proposal on the table that we need to discuss. This bipartisan bill is aiming to provide a $5,000 tax credit to alleviate the burden on family caregivers. Yes, you've heard that right, it's called the Credit for Caring Act. Now, let's break it down. This act would offer financial support to caregivers who are providing essential care to their loved ones, covering expenses like home care and adult day services. With more than 48 million caregivers in the U.S. alone, this bill could make a significant difference. Imagine, these caregivers collectively provide over $600 billion in unpaid care annually. That's a massive contribution. But here's the kicker: caregivers often have part-time or full-time jobs on top of their caregiving responsibilities. The average caregiver spent around $7,250 in out-of-pocket costs in 2021. And let's face it, that number probably went up in 2022 and 2023. The good news? This bill could offer some much-needed relief. Recently, a bipartisan group reintroduced the legislation, receiving support from AARP and members of Congress. They understand the struggles firsthand, as many of them have cared for loved ones themselves. But here's the deal: we're not out of the woods yet. This bill needs to pass through Congress and get the president's signature. It's a process, and as we all know, it can take some time. But if it does pass, caregivers could potentially receive an extra $5,000 in their pockets. That's a game changer for many families. Now, shifting gears a bit, let's talk about another piece of legislation in the works. The House is considering a more generous tax deduction for residents in high-tax states like New York City. Currently, deductions for state and local taxes are capped at $10,000, but lawmakers are looking to increase that limit. Representatives from high-tax states have been pushing for this change, aiming to provide relief for taxpayers. It's a step in the right direction, but we'll have to wait and see how it plays out. So, what are your thoughts on these developments? Do you think these bills will make a difference? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more updates on financial news and tips. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you in the next video.